It's called What a Difference a Day Makes. July 6th, 1971. I had tickets to go see Grand Funk Railroad that my mom had given me for my birthday for Shea Stadium. The day before, I'd shot $45 worth of dope. Now, you gotta remember, back then, bags were $2. So I shot close to 25 bags of dope that night, and I didn't really get that high. And I was not happy about it. So the next day, I go out, and I'm up at the park, Fort Tryon Park, and this guy, Bobby Marshall, comes down and goes, "Hey, I just burglarized an apartment. Come help me find stuff." And I had never done any burglaries. I had my own hustles. I just wasn't into mugging people or burglarizing or any of that shit. But I went with him. So me and this guy, little Jimmy, go with him up to this apartment. We walk in, and there's this little dog there, yapping, yapping, yapping. Finally, he gets tired and goes to sleep. So we look around. I go to the girl's room, and I find a box of earrings. And I just pierced my ear about a year before that, so I took one earring of everyone I liked, filled my pockets with that, found a couple other trinkets, and we go back to the park, and Bobby Marshall gives me $17. That was my take. So I know I'm going to the concert that night, and I said, you know, it would probably be nice if I got high before I went out there. So Jimmy tells me, if you cop at 180th Street, be really careful, because they have something out there that's the smoker. Back then, when you said it was the smoker, you meant it was the best dope possible. And this was the smoker. I go up to the Heights, and I meet another guy, Irish guy, Jimmy Toohey, that I grew up with. And he was with this other Irish guy, Sully, from the neighborhood. And then they were with this Puerto Rican junkie, Herbie. I didn't trust Herbie for shit. So I have enough money for 7 bags and my car fare to and from Shea Stadium. So I said to Jimmy, "Where do you want to cop?" He said, "Herbie knows where to cop. Herbie know, you know." So I was like, "Yeah, but I don't really trust Herbie." So he says, "No, no, no, no." So I said, "Okay, get 7 bags. I'll do 4. You guys can do 1 each." And they're like, "Oh no, man. I'm copping out 180th Street. I remember what Jimmy said. That's the smoker." But still, I didn't trust Herbie. It's like, "Nah, I'm doing 4. I did $45 worth last night and didn't get high. I want to make sure I get high tonight." The guy goes, "No, man, please don't do 4. And now I'm just thinking it's junkie bullshit. So I go, "Okay, here's the deal. I'll do 2. If I don't feel them 2, I'm doing 2 more, and then you guys can split the rest. No problem. You do that." You know, and that was unusual. I thought Herbie was going to try to hustle me some other way. So I get off first. That was the plan. I get off first. I do the 2 bags. Throw it in the cooker. They clean up. They cook up so clean. There's no residue. It's just like, and not much heat. It just melted. I was like, "Wow, cooked up pretty clean." So I draw up the shot, get a hit pretty quick, shoot it in, and I don't really feel it. You know, it's what we call the creeper. And it didn't come on right away, and I was like, "Oh man, I'm gonna have to do them other 2 bags." And you know, everybody's like, no man, wait. And then as soon as he said that, I felt it coming on, and I knew I was going out. I had fallen out before, but nothing like this. So I would say, "Move your works, move everything. I'm going up to the roof to get some air." You get some air, you think you can, you know, just walk around a bit, you won't go out. Which generally, you know, can work. I get up to the top, that's the last thing I remember, saying that I'm going for some air. They said I stood on the step and swayed back and forth for a minute and then fell on my face. So Sully was only snorting. He was a football player. The other guys did 2 bags each, and they were as high as I was. Of course, they got off before they decided to help me. Luckily, they didn't go out too. But Sully comes up first, decides to try to massage my heart. Now I'm laying on my stomach, and my face is on the tar paper, which had these little pebbles in it that acted like sandpaper on my face. He's massaging my heart, and my face is rubbing up and down, and it ripped all the skin off the left side of my face. Then he turns me over, and he's supposed to slap somebody. That might bring him out. He starts punching me. You know, my neck swells up, probably put me deeper into my OD. So this goes on, and they're like trying everything, and it's not working. They went down to Herbie's house and got ice. Ice under the armpits is supposed to work. No dice. They put ice under my balls. No dice. They pulled my pants down, put ice up my ass. That's the last resort. If that don't work, you're in trouble. It didn't work. Now here I am with my pants around my ankles, filthy from the rooftop, and the water mixture, and they're like, this ain't working, this guy's bad. So they decide to shoot me up with salt. It's old junkie folklore that salt neutralizes heroin. No, it doesn't. And not only that, it's hard to get a hit when someone's that bad into an OD because their blood pressure's so low, and I had lousy veins anyway, so they couldn't get a hit, so they decided to skin pop me with the salt. Bad move. The salt just went under the skin, and after a couple days, it started to turn this like really nice shade of turquoise. So this other guy, Frankie, comes up, sees me up there like that with my pants around my ankles. He said, this guy's dead. You better call the cops. Or if he's not dead, he's going to be. So he runs down, calls 911. The other guys leave. The cops come. They find me with all these earrings in my pocket and tell my parents I'm a burglar. So they get me to the hospital. I'm unconscious at least a good day and a half, 2 days. I finally wake up and my mom shows me a mirror. And the left side of my face is one big scab. My hair is all caked in blood, and I'm swolled up around the mug all over the place. So I was like, that's pretty. So they wouldn't let me have any visitors. Everybody I called wanted to know where I got that dope. Where's your cop? Everybody wanted that dope. I was like, hey man, don't ask me nothing about that dope. So this goes on. Now it turns out I have an abscess in my arm. They start to shoot me up with antibiotics, and they said, we're gonna have to lance your arm. So it blows up and it splits and turns into two abscesses. So now they're gonna have to cut me twice. The first time they cut you, they take you up to the operating room, and you have they paint Benadine all over your arm, some sort of antiseptic, I assume. And they slit you open, and it parts like the Red Sea, all this blood and pus, and they squeeze it all out, and they put gauze in. And then every day you have to pull the gauze out of this little slit on your arm, and it's a ball about this big. So you're pulling this pus-laden ball out of your arm, and it hurts like hell, but you gotta do it. So they did the first operation, and it went pretty well, and I'm like, okay. They said, we're gonna have to cut you again. I was like, I'm not going through this again. I was ready to leave right there. If I had, I probably would have lost my arm. I had a guy gonna bring me clothes so I could sneak out that night, but I didn't get out. I ended up having the operation done. They cut me open again, but this time they forgot to cover my face. So I look as the guy slits, and like I say, it was like the Red Sea parting, and just blood all over, and I look up to the doctor's eyes, and the doctor looks at me and he goes, nurse, cover his face. They don't want you to see you get cut. It's not good patient relations. So they squeezed all the pus out. They ended up getting, supposedly I heard, 22 ounces of pus out of my arm. So after 2 weeks, the arm starts to heal. They tell me I'm going home. I wake up that morning, I turn on the radio, and Bob Dylan's New Morning is playing. And I felt, yeah, this is a new morning. I'm clean, I don't have a habit. My parents decided to take me to Jamaica with them. First they weren't gonna take me because I was a junkie. Now they were taking me because I was a junkie. And I'm really happy. I go out that night, I didn't get high. I went to Central Park to see the Allman Brothers with Dwayne Allman still in them. And I met a girl. Didn't get any, but it looked good. Everything was going well. Turns out the girl wanted that dope. That's why she was with me. But I didn't get it for her. She ended up going out with Herbie after that, which is really weird. So I get up, I go out of the hospital. I'm feeling great. The next day, I get up in the morning, and I was like, shit, I feel like getting high. So I end up in the same park where I copped the dope the night 2 weeks before, and shot up in the same arm with these two big holes in my arm about 3/4 inch deep, and I thought to myself, wow, what a difference a day makes. Thanks a lot. I appreciate you coming out. Mark Sewall. Mark is on.